Well, Congress will likely approve another $2 million to keep the popular Cash for Clunkers program operating. That's good news for some, but not salvage yards. Kim Gebbia is standing by live to tell us why. Kim?
Wanda, call it the rusty underbelly of this Cash for Clunkers program. Some salvage yard owners fear that when they bring those clunkers to scrap metal shops like the one behind me, they won't be getting near as much cash as they hoped for.
If I tried to crank it right now, it should be locked up.
Another clunker engine bites the dust, but this 98 Explorer still contains plenty of profitable parts for the owner of the High Point salvage yard.
I mean, it's still got some good body parts left on it. I mean, there's a lot of body panels that I could sell, wheels, tires.
The catch, Slick Yeomans only has 6 months to make that profit before the government says this clunker must be crushed.
It would probably make somewhere around $800.
The program will create short-term business, but Yeomans worries 6 months from now, clunkers will cause the scrap metal business to bottom out.
The value of the scrap metal is going to go down because you're going to be processing all these cars at once, and which is going to drive the price of the metal down.
More supply than demand, a problem easily solved if these clunkers could be resold.
It's a shame for somebody to, to crush this car, this particular vehicle here, shame for them to, get rid of it, dispose of it when it could be useful to somebody else.
Someone like Maria Thomas.
There's really no reason to have them destroyed.
These are the only wheels Thomas rides. She wishes the program would help folks like herself who can't afford a new car payment but could pay for a deal on a beat-up old clunker.
A 98 Ford Explorer is not that old. It really isn't. How would it help me? I could get to doctor's appointments a lot better. I could get to the food banks. I could get there and get bags of food instead of just like what I could carry.
Instead, perfectly good cars will be destroyed.
You just take the good with the bad.
Now, those clunkers are being crushed in order to take those fuel inefficient cars off the road. So far, that aspect of the program does seem to be working. The average mile per gallon of the clunkers being turned in is around 15.5, and the average miles per gallon of the new cars being bought is about 10 miles less at 15 miles per gallon. Reporting live in Winston-Salem, I'm Kim Gebbia, WXII 12 News.